The Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, has urged local lawyers to position themselves and take up the huge government contracts rather than waiting to be subcontracted by foreign law firms.
Because the foreigners want you to be subcontractors. They want to get the big deal, then they look for you as a subcontractor. You do the donkey work, then you're paying peanuts. In other words, they're saying you're a monkey.
He made the call during the annual law conference 2023 at Speak Resort in Munyonyo. The two-day conference is being organized by the Uganda Law Society under the theme Redefining Legal Practice in the Age of Disruption. The Justice Minister noted that when there is a big arbitration case in the Attorney General's chambers, they always contract the services of foreign lawyers, yet we have good lawyers in the country who can handle such cases.
There has been a belief that in the Attorney General's chambers previously, that when you have like a big arbitration case of hundreds of millions, then you go to the internet, you start looking for foreign lawyers. And you people are here. You fight with the army you have. You're our army. Which we are not going to borrow an army to fight. And I'm sure the Attorney General should have given his testimony of finding that actually there are some very, very good Ugandan lawyers who can tackle arbitration issues.
He noted that there are some unscrupulous government lawyers who connive with litigants who have dragged the government to court because they want to gain something, resulting in the government losing huge sums of money.
Because somehow our parliament has decided to respond to an outcry in the society and enact a bill which some people are not happy with. But there it is, that is the parliament of Uganda. It is the prevailing sentiment in the country. So now other people want to punish us financially. So we must do everything possible to save government money.
In his address, the Attorney General, Chidiowa Chiwanuka, said Uganda's journey through the disruptive age is intricately woven into the fabric of the country's National Development Plan 3. Disclosed that the comprehensive plan outlined 17 key programs, each designed as a goal to propel the nation forward. Chiwanuka, however, said embracing these transformational journeys requires legal practitioners to break away from conventional norms, approaches, and methods of doing business.
Each designed as a goal to propel the nation forward. I will highlight a few, but to encourage all of you to familiarize yourselves with this plan. I am happy that Dr. Mubawala, the architect of this and the custodian of this, is here to speak to you today, and I will be very interested to listen to what he has to say about the NDP 3.
Chiwanuka also noted that the legal landscape is evolving, advising practitioners to consider reorganizing firms into specialized departments or collaborate with other firms.
If you want to survive in practice, I encourage you to get the NDP 3 and read it. At least, if you can't read it, Dr. Mwara has a very big document, very, very big. But if you cannot read all the 17 programs, even if you cannot read the governance security program where we actually sit, for purposes of business, I encourage you to read those 7 that I've highlighted.
The Uganda Law Society President Bernard Owundo said the society recently petitioned the Uganda Registration Service Bureau on the issue of employing non-lawyers, arguing that most of the work done in the company registry requires an understanding of the law. Owundo revealed that last year 1,500 students graduated from LDC and the Uganda Law Society currently has 5,000 members. This means that in the next 2 years, unified judicial system will have over 8,000 lawyers and the opportunities will shrink.
The issue is also about the competitiveness that is coming out because of the numbers of students emerging from the Law Development Center. As I have stated, last year alone you had 1,500 students coming from the Law Development Center. Today, currently, you have 5,000 members of the Uganda Law Society. Now, what that means is that in the next 1 or 2 years, given the numbers coming from the Law Development Center, you're going to have over 8,000 lawyers.
Story compiled by Ismail Nsubuga for the news.